The next item of business is topical questions. In order to get in as many people as possible, I'd be grateful for short and succinct questions and responses. And I call question number one, Maggie Chapman.
Thank you. To ask the Scottish Government what its position is on the reported use of kettling during the recent protests in Glasgow.
Cabinet Secretary Keith Brown.
The right to peacefully protest is not only a crucial component to the success of COP26, it is a right that is fully supported by the Scottish Government. And as we enter the second week of COP26, Glasgow has lived up to its proud tradition of activism and of peaceful protest, and that is a source of pride for the whole of Scotland. The policing of the summit is, of course, an operational matter for the Chief Constable, who has been clear from the start that the planning and delivery for the event would be compliant with human rights legislation. It would facilitate peaceful and lawful protest and ensure public safety.
Maggie Chapman.
I appreciate that operational matters rest with the Chief Constable, but this Parliament sets the limits within which the police can operate, and it's important to understand the Government's position in relation to those limits. Police officers declare to, and I quote, uphold fundamental human rights and accord equal respect to all people, end quote. I am concerned that some of the tactics deployed during the COP have not taken account of those important principles. The use of kettling tactics on peaceful protesters seems wholly disproportionate. I've read reports of journalists kettled for hours with no access to water or toilets, and of a young mother with a baby in a pram trapped in a kettle. It can't be right that children are being kettled. Does the Cabinet Secretary think that kettling is a proportionate tactic to use when dealing with peaceful protest?
Cabinet Secretary.
Can I thank the member for her question? I should say I've had daily conversations with Police Scotland throughout COP26 and actually regular conversations beforehand. And I am satisfied that they have tried extremely hard to make sure that they have facilitated protest and that their response has been proportionate. I think there have been 300 different protests. The vast majority, according to Maggie Chapman's own words in her letter, quite rightly to Police Scotland, acknowledge the fact that the very vast majority of protests have been taken, have been peaceful and also been accommodated by a flexible response from the police. In relation to the points that she raises, I should say the independent review group met on the 5th of November to discuss some of these issues which have been raised subsequently by her but also by others beforehand, and meets again today as well to discuss these issues. And it's right they should do that. It's also right the member should, if she has concerns, write to Police Scotland. And it may be something, of course, that the police authority looks at in due course as well, but I am satisfied from all the conversations I've had from Police Scotland that they have tried to be as proportionate as possible to facilitate protest and certainly to work within the bounds of legislation set for them by this Parliament.
Maggie Chapman.
Can I thank the Cabinet Secretary for that response? At Saturday's Climate March, one particular group of marchers was subjected to a police kettle from the moment they arrived at Kelvin Grove Park without clear cause. As the march passed through the city centre, the kettled group were halted by the police and prevented from moving any further. This in turn prevented thousands of other marchers behind this group from continuing with the march. There were minors in this kettle, and this group just wanted to continue marching along with everyone else. Can the Cabinet Secretary confirm the legal status of kettling in such a situation, and whether or not he has any concerns about the conduct of the officers involved? Many of whom, as colleagues in the Chamber can confirm, did not seem to know what was happening or who was in control.
Cabinet Secretary.
I would first of all repeat to Maggie Chapman the point I made about the independent review group, which has on it, of course, John Scott and also some of the organisations which made complaints along the lines that Maggie Chapman has just mentioned. And I'm advised that was a very constructive meeting. The police would refer to that as moving containment. And they would also say that where they've done this is because, in one example, the protesters that had sat down in front of the march were stopping the rest of the march from taking place and presenting a danger to the public. I would say that, of course, as I've mentioned already, it's open to any members of the Parliament, indeed anybody, to make a complaint to Police Scotland. It will be for them to address the points which have been raised. But I think the independent review group, containing many of the people, for example, Friends of the Earth, who have made raised concerns, has had one discussion on this, is having a second discussion today, and I hope that's how these things can be resolved.
Russell Findlay.
Thank you. Will the Cabinet Secretary join me in condemning those who tried to antagonise the police into confrontation and commend the brave officers for stepping in to stop disruptive protesters?
Cabinet Secretary.
Mr Findlay, this is a good point. I mean, there are examples of officers having spray paint or at least liquid sprayed into their eyes, and then reverting back to the front line immediately afterwards. There are examples of officers being hit over the head with banners, many of whom are goaded. This applies to a very small minority of the thousands of people that have been involved in this march, but it is wrong, and I would condemn it, and I would praise the officers concerned.
Colette Stevenson.
To ask the Scottish Government what actions Scottish Government and delivery partners have taken to support peaceful relations at COP26.
Cabinet Secretary.
We fully recognise, of course, that there should be a clear dialogue between the protesters, police and others, and I wouldn't underestimate the extent to which this happened long before COP26 started. But the dialogue has included discussions at the marches themselves at COP26, and they can, of course, help to de-escalate tensions and allow protesters to exercise their right to protest while maintaining public order. And that's why the Scottish Government has funded the Keeping Our Cool initiative, which is ensuring that independent mediators are present at protests and marches throughout COP26 and are able to intervene wherever appropriate to facilitate dialogue between protesters, police and others to achieve positive outcomes.
Thank you. Question number two, Jamie Green.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. To ask the Scottish Government to comment on reports that emergency workers were assaulted whilst on duty during bonfire night weekend.
Cabinet. Oh, Minister Ash Regan.
The Scottish Government is appalled that anyone should make such despicable attacks on emergency service workers, and our thoughts are with those who were injured. And I'm pleased to have been informed that all are expected to make a full recovery. Both Police Scotland and the Scottish Fire and Rescue Service have reported that call numbers were significantly down this year. The Scottish Fire and Rescue Service has specifically advised that the number of attacks on crew fell by a third. However, there is still an unacceptable level of antisocial behaviour within our communities relating to fireworks. I am engaging with our emergency services as they debrief and analyse the data to ensure that we maintain this downward trend in call-outs and also maximise the protection given to those who are called out. I'm committed to bringing forward the bill that was announced in our programme for government to implement the remaining recommendations of the Independent Fireworks Review Group.
Jamie Green.
Can I thank the Minister? And the front bench is right to condemn attacks on police, both at COP26 and during bonfire night. It is really a great shame in our society that this happens year after year after year. And whilst the numbers are going down, any attack is still unacceptable. The attacks of the weekend were horrific, Presiding Officer. Police and fire crews were assaulted with fireworks, with golf clubs, and one required hospitalisation. But this Parliament too must send a strong and simple message to the public that attacking our emergency service workers is simply not on. In that tone, can I ask the Minister, therefore, why the Scottish Government will not support our proposals to double the maximum penalty for assault under the Emergency Workers Act from 12 months to 2 years?
Minister.
The misuse of fireworks in our communities is not acceptable, and I believe that message has been sent out very clearly, both from this Parliament and also from all of our partners, including the Scottish Fire and Rescue Service and Police Scotland. And for anyone who's misusing fireworks, that line is very clear from our prosecutors, from our courts, that people who offend will be dealt with robustly. We condemn any attack on our emergency services, and it is a relief, as I was able to report to the Chamber, that the personnel that were injured will be able to make full recoveries. And it's hoped that ongoing police inquiries will identify the perpetrators. Where we have powers, Presiding Officer, we have acted. And that applies to fireworks, and it applies to sentences for attacks on police officers and firefighters. We obviously have the Emergency Workers Act of 2005, and that supplements the common law and has specific offences which can be used, which carry a sentence of up to 12 months in custody. We're always prepared to keep the law under review, as I'm sure the member would be aware, but we have no real evidence that sentencing rules are encouraging criminality. So to help bring those offenders to book, I would encourage anyone with any information about these senseless attacks on our emergency services or about any wider disturbances that occurred to contact the police. And they can do that either directly or they can do it anonymously through Crime Stoppers.
Jamie Green.
The Minister wants some evidence that the current common law legislation is not enough. Let me give the Minister some evidence. Last year, assaults on emergency workers rose to an all-time high of over 8,000 incidents. That was up 600 year on year. If that's not evidence, I don't know what is, Minister. And in 1819, 160 people were convicted under the Emergency Workers Act, which in Scotland does carry a maximum sentence of just 12 months. If you couple that with the presumption against short sentences, the end result is that fewer than a third actually went to jail for assaulting emergency services workers. Other parts of the UK have rightly doubled that ceiling from 12 months to 2 years. So let me ask again, why can't we do the same in Scotland?
Minister.
As I said to the member, we are always prepared to keep the law under review. And I do not have the evidence that sentencing rules, and I mean sentencing rules, are encouraging that criminality. We have a range of tools that the police and the prosecutors can use. And for offences of this type and for serious offences, there are obviously imprisonment of up to life imprisonment. So the courts have at their disposal the tools, I believe, to be able to prosecute these offences appropriately. In terms of fireworks and the misuse around fireworks, I'm sure the member is aware that this government is very committed to bringing that under control. We have a number of short and also longer term, both legislative and non-legislative action in order to curtail this. We've obviously set up the Fireworks Review Group to look at how Scotland's regime of sale and use of fireworks could be improved, and I am committed to progressing those recommendations. We've obviously changed the law this year, and the early signs are from the Gold Commanders that I spoke to last year that that has had a positive effect. We have also funded a number of public awareness campaigns, and we've also funded trading standard officers for education and enforcement. So this government is committed to curtailing the misuse of fireworks and to creating a regime, both in sentencing and legislatively, that will improve Scotland's relationship with fireworks.
Audrey Nicholl.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I'd like to begin by acknowledging that call-out numbers this year were down. However, much work still needs to be done. As such, can I ask the Minister what progress the Scottish Government has made in implementing the recommendations of the Independent Fireworks Review Group to ensure that fireworks are used safely and appropriately going forward?
Minister.
Yes, so the Scottish Government set up the Independent Fireworks Review Group, and that was chaired by the former Chief Fire Officer, Alistair Hay. And that was to undertake a thorough review of the evidence on the sale and the use of fireworks, including data on the impact of fireworks use in Scotland, and look at international case studies. I welcomed the group's recommendations last year and committed to progressing these as soon as possible. And so we've already legislated to implement a number of recommendations, which means that this year the times of day and the volume of fireworks that can be supplied to the general public are restricted, as are the times of day that fireworks can be set off. And following a consultation this summer, we will shortly be introducing primary legislation, and that's to implement the group's remaining recommendations. And together with the non-legislative actions that we're also progressing with our partners, we are aiming to deliver a fundamental change in the culture of Scotland's relationship with fireworks to better protect both our communities and also our emergency services.
Thank you. That concludes topical questions. I'll allow a moment while we rearrange ourselves.